The First Day of School by R.V. Castle, Part 3. He blinked at the sun's glare on the concrete steps leading down to the porch. He remembered something else from the time he was little. Once, he had kicked Audrey's doll buggy down these same steps. He had done it out of meanness. From some silly reason, he had been mad at her. But as soon as the buggy had started to bump down, he had understood how terrible it was not to be able to run after it and stop it. It had gathered speed at each step, and when it hit the sidewalk, it had spilled over. Audrey's doll had smashed into sharp little pieces on the sidewalk below. His mother had come out of the house to find him crying harder than Audrey. "Now you know that when something gets out of your hands, it is in the devil's hands," his mother had explained to him. Did she expect him to forget, now, that that was always the way things went, to smash when they got out of hand? Again he heard the siren and the hooting, mocking horns from the center of town. Didn't his mother think that they could get out of hand? He closed his eyes and seemed to see something like a doll buggy bump down long steps like those at Joseph P. Gilmore High, and it seemed to him that it was not the doll that was riding down to be smashed. He made up his mind then. He would go today, because he had said he would. Therefore, he had to. But he wouldn't go unless Audrey stayed home. That was going to be his condition. His bargaining looked perfect. He would trade them one for one. His mother and Audrey came together onto the porch. His mother said, "My stars, I forgot to give you money for the groceries." She let the screen door bang as she went swiftly back into the house. As soon as they were alone, he took Audrey's bare arm in his hand and he pinched it hard. "You gotta stay home," he whispered. "Don't you know there's thousands of people down there? Didn't you hear them coming in all night long? You slept, didn't you? All right, you can hear them now. Tell her you're sick. She won't expect you to go if you're sick. I'll knock you down. I'll smash you if you don't tell her that." He bared his teeth and twisted his nails into her skin of her arm. "Hear them horns?" he hissed. He forced her halfway to her knees with the strength of his fear and rage. They swayed there, locked for a minute. Her knee dropped to the porch floor. She lowered her eyes. He thought he had won.